so many items, gear, materials. What do you keep? What's important? Don't accidentally sell something that's valuable. It can be stressful, and since we do not have unlimited inventory, there are some decisions you're gonna have to make. But don't worry, I'm here to help. If you had just started Final Fantasy or a little ways into it, then this video is tailor-made for you. As always, this is my personal opinion, but for the most part backed up by facts. Stay tuned to the end where I give you my personal pro tips for your inventory management. What's up guys, my name is Stefan Ash and I have another Final Fantasy practical guide for you. Today we'll be talking about the big topic, inventory management for Final Fantasy XIV. If at any time you get value out of this video, then limit break through that subscribe button down below. Let's jump into the video. For new players and sprouts, let's go over the general basics of inventory. Your character has 140 slots of inventory, as well as a space for key items and quest-specific items. Once you hit level 17 for the main story, you will unlock retainers, two in fact. These are considered your main source of storage. Each retainer has 175 slots. Once you get your chocobo, you also have a chocobo saddlebag, which is 70 slots. We also have slots in your armory chest, which is where your equipables for your job and classes are, weapons and gears and accessories specifically. There are spaces to use here, but I don't include them because I hate leaving things in there just to pile up. I keep this as clean as I play with all jobs and classes and just want what I need in there. Needless to emphasize that we have a limited amount of storage that we have accessible. For brand new players, I want to point out that you can purchase more retainers and they cost about $2 a month for each extra one, up to 9 retainers. You can also purchase the companion app for $5 a month, which will then give you another retainer with a total of 10 retainers that are available for you. I myself don't use the companion app, I just have the 9 retainers that I pay for, but I do endgame crafting and all sorts of other things that I need a lot of storage for, and I play this game pretty much every single day. I am not saying you need to purchase retainers, but if you find you need more storage or you want to get into crafting and gathering, then more retainers might be right for you. With that out of the way, let's talk about the perspective of this video. I will be explaining the inventory management from someone who is just starting the game. You may have just started, or you're probably halfway or maybe close to the end, but your inventory is starting to get filled up and you want to sell some stuff or clear some storage. So with that perspective, let's focus in. The first thing to go over is the item settings. Let's adjust these to my liking. You can take or leave this part, whatever works better for you. You can go over to character configuration under item settings. Inventory interface, we're actually going to change this to open all, which means your full inventory, all 4 slots will show instead of a semi-closed inventory where you have to tab over. I like this setting because I like to see everything in one view and don't like to have to move back and forth between menus. All other settings I keep the same. Let's move on to what we should keep and not keep. As I cannot physically go through every specific item, I'm going to give you a step-by-step proper guideline for each type of item to decide if you need it or not. I use this method to keep my inventory nice, clean, and organized at all times with little effort. First up is a doozy, gear. First thing first, don't ever sell your gear to an NPC vendor. This is your last resort, as I'm going to give you a multitude of ways that gear can benefit you otherwise. I just wanted to get that out of the way first. Gear is a consistent thing that you'll be obtaining through your adventures. When starting off in Eorzea, and if you're under level 50, you should constantly equip new gear that is better than your old gear. It is important that you keep your item level near the dungeon and story level in order to not fall behind in damage. If you are wondering why you should be rolling on every piece of gear in a dungeon, because you are rolling on your gear, right? Then you just need to watch my video about what sprouts always miss. That will explain why you need to roll on your gear. I use the following method in order to determine what to do with my gear. Number 1, is it better than my current gear? Easy to check, you can just use the item comparison button to see if it's better stat-wise. Do not equip gear for glamour, as we have a separate glamour system for that, which will have to be a different video. Comment down below if you want to see that one. Focus only on the stats, or hit the recommended button to equip the best gear possible. A note here is that it has to be in your armory chest for the recommended button to work. It will not work if your gear is in the inventory, but you can still use the item comparison button to check. If better, then equip. If not, leave in your inventory. We have a special use for unused gear that my video Farming Grand Company Seals that will be coming out soon is gonna go over. Number two, can my retainers use this gear? When you have your retainers and of course you choose a job for them, which should be your main job that you're playing throughout the story, then you can pass on your old gear as your retainers level up. Example being if you're a level 48 Dragoon and you have a level 35 retainer with the Lancer Dragoon class, you can give your gear to that retainer so you don't have to purchase gear. Best way to recycle class gear. Another note here, make sure that you don't switch your retainer's job often, as every time you switch because you decided you want to play through the story with another character or another job, I should say, it starts over at level 1. Number 3, can I sell my gear? As long as you do not equip and spirit bond with the gear, which means just attacking or killing an enemy with it equipped, it is sellable through retainers. Some dungeon gear early on is sellable that are not job specific. Dungeon gear later on will be untradeable, which means you cannot sell it through a retainer. But crafted gear and gear you get through quest or story quest are sellable. Your retainer is the way you sell on the market board in Final Fantasy XIV. You can simply go to your retainer, sell items in inventory, and see if you have something that is worth selling. Not all gear is worth it, and just because gear doesn't look worth it doesn't mean it's not worth it, if that makes any sense. What I'm trying to say is just double check, because you might have a piece of gear that sells for a lot of money that you didn't think it would. Or you might have a special piece of gear that you're like, this is gonna sell for a lot, and it only sells for 200 gil. You should make it a good habit to check your gear in the market board for the prices for some easy money, because you never know who's looking for what. You'll have to go back and adjust the price every so often, but easy gil for doing pretty much nothing. Number 4, can I get Grand Company seals with it? We will keep it in our inventory for our Grand Company Seal Farming or GC Farming, which you can unlock after main quest level 20 and you choose a Grand Company. Once you unlock the special method, you can simply turn in the gear for GC Seals or Grand Company Seals and exchange those seals for all sorts of awesome things. Check the description below, as I will have that video linked when I post it. The number 5 method for gear is desynthesis. Desynthesizing is unlocked with any level 30 crafter, so there is a little bit barrier of an entry for this method. If you can't do any of the remaining above steps, you can desynthesize gear, which will give you a breakdown of what the materials were to make the piece of gear. Sometimes you can do this with dungeon loot, but honestly, this is really more for crafters and gatherers who need that kind of material or crystals for crafting. If you're a beginner, then I would not worry about this method to start with. If you do not have your first clear with the main story, I would not worry about keeping gear for lots of jobs or alt classes. Broken record, but focus on getting through the main story first. And if you only have 2 retainers, it's not worth keeping it just so you can equip it later. You might as well profit off it now and sell it for gil or get Grand Company seals for it. A pro tip is that gear you get from the main story quest, if you don't need them to equip, which you shouldn't after level 50. I have a video talking about gearing with Poetics after level 50, and that will explain the reason why. But back to this gear that you can get from the main story quest. You can usually sell this gear for quite a bit of gil, and this is a great way to start building your gil reserves as you go through the story. I wouldn't worry about which one you choose from the quest, but it's awesome to see things sell for 5,000, 10,000 gil, sometimes 80,000 gil for something that you just did by doing the main story. My priority list for how I handle gear is as follows. Equip to job. If not, equip to retainer. If not, sell on market board. If I can't do that, then turn it into Grand Company seals. I very rarely desynthesize things unless I'm crafting. The really important pieces of gear that are race-specific or job-specific can be attained again by special vendors for the race, which is this vendor right here, or be purchased again on the market board. I can't think of one piece of gear that you should have to keep that you cannot obtain again. As always, for my keyboard warriors, if I miss something, then comment down below under my pinned comment so Sprouts can read through it to see if they missed something or need to know something. I am not all-knowing and I make mistakes all the time, so that's why I like to say that for people to keep learning and correct me if I'm wrong. Let's move on to crafting materials. Honestly, any of these you can quite frankly sell either through the market board or to your retainer NPC vendor if they don't sell for much on the market board. My philosophy is if I can buy it from the market board, then I don't have to worry about keeping it. You can simply go to your retainer and check the prices on the market board for a particular crafting item. Sometimes you'll come across really cool things that are worth a lot of money and you could sell. And sometimes they're only worth one gil and there's really no reason to keep it. If you are new, I recommend checking every item first before selling it because you're not sure if something is worthwhile or not. Once you play for a while, you'll start seeing the same trend in things and just different types. Example being copper ore, tin ore, silver ore, so on and so forth. You can keep high quality things if you know you're gonna get into some crafting. But even then, it might not be worth the space if you're only running on two retainers. If you're still really unsure and you can't tell and you're worried, then just do a quick Google search to make sure it's not anything super special. But very rarely does that happen. Anything obtained from enemy kills falls under this as well, like skins and leathers and such. Sometimes you can get some good materials that will sell for a good amount, at which point you can just sell them for gil and make some money. Next up, materia. I am actually thinking of doing a materia and melding guide, so comment down below if you want to see that. Materia is actually quite important in this game as these add stats for your jobs. You should not worry about melding materia before endgame though, but you should keep all of your materia. You will get methods later to turn this materia into better materia, and you never know what materia you're gonna need. I honestly think it's worth it, and it does pay off later as some critical hit materia can go for 10,000 to 20,000 per piece. Next up, food. Generally, you wanna keep all your food, even if the stats don't align with your class or job at the moment. The main reason is that food gives you an experience boost, which you are not at level 80. You should have food going at all times. 3% stacks up over a long run and will surmount to millions of experience by the time you get to the end of the game. That's why you always want to keep food running. Any food you get, keep and use it and always have that 30 or 60 minute timer running. You can also buy the cheapest food from the main city's culinarian for any culinarian vendor for super cheap just to get that experience bonus. Have I hit home how important it is to have food running? Don't worry about the stats as they're negligible before endgame. You're better off focusing on keeping gear up to date than spending money on food that might boost your stats a little bit. Same with food, I do keep all my dyes. I'm not saying you have to though, because you can get the majority of dyes from the market board. I just had enough retainers in order to do that. So if you want to keep your dyes and you have the space, then keep them. It will save you some hassle later, but you can also just get rid of them and purchase them later. You can also check the prices on the market board because you might come across that go for a good little hefty chunk of gil. Next up, housing items. I'm going to leave this up to you. Since I have 9 retainers, I do keep my housing items, but you need a house in order to utilize them anyway. Since houses are very hard to come by at the moment in Final Fantasy XIV, I would just say sell it for money or desynthesize it for materials. Okay, so now some of my few pro tips. Read your item tooltips. This will give you an idea as to what the item is used for. Examples are these cracked clusters that you get from leveling roulette. These can be turned in for materia, which are super important and we'll go over later in a different video. Reading the tooltips of each item will help you start understanding what items are used for and how they are related to each other. Do not miss out on items just because you didn't read the tooltips. untradeable items. You will come across a lot of untradeable items in the game. Many not important, and there's just as many that are. If you're unsure, then always look up that item and see what it's used for. The great thing is if you obtained it once, then it's obtainable again, so you don't have to be concerned. And just because something isn't useful to you now, doesn't mean it's not going to be useful to you later. I have a horror story about this. I first started playing Copied Factory and got a ton of the coins associated with the Nier Automata raid, and I discarded them because I didn't think I was going to need them. And fast forward today, where you need one of each coin in order to get the highest level item right before Endwalker. So take it from me, don't discard things just because you don't need them now. Just hold on to them if you have the inventory space, because you might need them later. Again, anything you get from dungeons or trials is always obtainable again, so you don't have to worry about discarding untradeable items from there. It goes without saying that if you're working on a relic, then you probably shouldn't discard any of that. There are items that you cannot get unless you have a certain quest going. A relic is one of those examples. Shadowbringer's relic is you need memories. You can only get these memories once you have the quest active, and they're just going to sit there until you get enough of them. So just be mindful of what you're working on and what quests you have active. Lastly, here is a view of my inventory and retainers and how I keep things. I have them split out by different classes of items, such as endgame crafting materials in one retainer, alchemy materials in another, materia in another, dyes for another, and housing items for the last one. Don't be afraid to ask other players if something is important or not. The community is so phenomenal and could really come through in a pinch if you're not sure if you need something. All in all, I didn't find the inventory run out quickly. I felt like I had a lot of inventory through the whole entire game. The biggest thing is just the crafting materials that are a lot, and I just sold all those and I did fairly well. I want to thank you all for watching. If you're into social medias and things, then I have my links down below for my Facebook and Instagram, as well as my community Discord, which is just a great place to ask questions and learn all things about Final Fantasy for new players and sprouts. As always, if you want to watch more Final Fantasy tutorials, then you can click here.